So I think a lot of tools, and I like to emphasize, positive options that are out there. I see what you do that, it doesn't look real bright in the immediate future at the moment, although I don't mean, think that that has to be assumed as guaranteed, because we don't want to make it a self-fulfilling prophecy. But no matter how dark it is, the reason people like seeing the heroes in the Alamo is because they didn't just lie on the floor and just give up and say, well, this is all terrible, we have no chance or anything. They were really courageous and used all their time as well as they could to do something good. And I think we're in a situation that's not entirely dissimilar to that, but we also could have a better outcome. We don't know, because we're walking around with potential that has been completely forgotten.
Well, and that's part of the goal. The power, there's several ways to look at it. And I mean, the power really is in the people. I mean, the people who are destroying our lives and have been doing it for a long, long time derive their power from the people. And if you're in a in a simple, and the simplest expression of this, I think, is that if you work in a profession where you're actually enforcing immoral or destructive policies, then maybe you're part of the problem.
Well, they
not
are,
saying
but they
you.
don't know what to do because there's not a lot of good jobs to get after you lose yours, right?
Right. I was going to say that I have compassion for people because you've got to have a job, and I get that. You've got to have a job, but it's a tough situation to be in, and we
You
need.
can be a contact tracer if you lose your regular job. And I also just read that one of the best careers that's opening up is diversity officer, teaching kids to change gender and stuff like that,
Oh,
But it's a hard question, because I have a friend who's a scientist guy who came here and is really a good person and lost his income. And now his wife is left supporting their house payments and everything. She works for a pharmacy, nice name for a drug dealer, basically, but she works for them. And they're announcing that they're going to force people to take the vaccine, but it's totally optional because they can quit.
Right. What are
She's
the
their
options?
only income.
Right. Your option is going to be you can't buy, you can't sell, you can't
Exactly.
travel, you can't cross the state lines, you can't go to your neighbors, you can't go to church, you can't go shopping.
Right.
So, but you're still free.
It's
You know,
voluntary.
it's voluntary, but you can't live unless you do it.
Right. And those, it's okay with the conditions because they're just being enforced by private companies.
Right.
Pretty
Right.
big ones, but, theoretically private companies.
Exactly.
I don't know the practical answer to that, because I feel like I can't tell somebody, well, obviously give up all your money and be homeless because it's the right thing to do. Unless you're in that position and you do that, you don't really know what it feels like.
Yeah, it's a
Right.
very tough position, and I think that's part of the reason we need free communication today, is the more people who realize the dire situation we're under and the corruption we're under,
Yeah.
that it doesn't have to be this way. We have to change our behavior. We have to change our mindset, and we have
Yeah.
to start acting differently, and we have to start, not allowing corruption to rule over us. We have to start
Right.
holding them accountable.
And realizing that what one person does is hugely important, and it can snowball like you were describing before.
Yeah, the ripple effect. It's no person is an island in themselves. You're affecting people around you all the time. So do it for good. Use them
Yes,
for
and I
good.
think we're affecting everybody, because we're actually radiating frequencies ourselves as a living being.
And I
And
think even the
it's
words we say, yeah.
the words too, but I'm saying at a distance even, what comes out of us is unknown. It's like people know about the cell tower frequency, even though they can't see it or smell it or anything. It's really powerful at a distance. But people think they don't have any similar resonant effect on the atmosphere. And I think we do, but it's not going to be obvious unless we stop it from being all fear-based and scattered and everything, everybody just revving each other's fear up. And the one that gets focused and positive is stronger.
And the two things, you know, the two components we talked about earlier is don't, you know, they're trying to take your inspiration away, your drive.
Yeah.
They're also trying to take your knowledge away. Both of those things are under attack right now.
Censorship.
Yeah.
And they're trying to say, look into the indefinite future. You're really not going to be able to go out of your house or ever take your mask off. In fact, somebody, I think was either Biden or Fauci said that, oh, it was Cuomo. Sorry. It was trying to be a really good example for the rest of the world. He's saying two masks are going to be necessary through at least 2022.
Yeah. And this is the boil the frogs. They start out by saying, oh, just a couple months.
15 days.
Oh, well, a couple months, now half a year. Now we're years into the future. And I knew from the beginning this is what was going to happen because I know the agenda.
They're all excited because they found out how to do it. Fear of a germ.
Fear. And I made a post about that a couple of weeks ago, is that fear is the force that they utilize to strip you of all the things you would never normally give away.
It just works better than anything else. It has thousands of years of verified testing. And it's had consistent results.
It is. Even in placebo-controlled studies, fear does work, yes.
Yeah. And people are willing to blindly follow authority to try to overcome fear. So, you know, the experiments, you know, people were taken off the street and say, well, you just have to give a shock to this person who gets the wrong answer, and we'll tell you if it's the wrong answer. And that person's behind a screen, and they're screaming, and they're dying, and 70 or 80% of the people off the street are willing to kill if a person in a white coat says to do it.
Yeah, the Milgram experiment. And that's where something very fascinating, social pressure, is also based on fear. When people are afraid of what their friends are going to think of them because they're a conspiracy theorist. And it's like, I tell people, one of the things you can do is stop being afraid of what people think about you in the short term.
Yeah.
Be more concerned about what people think about you in the long term, because we're right about this stuff that we're talking about.
Right.
And in the short term, they might not approve of what you're saying. But one day, if you don't speak up now, they'll come to you and say, why didn't you tell me when you knew? And that's the boat. I don't ever want to be in that
position. That's right. And a lot of the ones that don't outright die from the vaccine will figure out, wait a minute, that might not have been a good idea. How do I fix myself? You know, and that's hard to do with the DNA corrupting vaccine.
I don't know the way back from this vaccine.
I'm really interested in finding out if there is one, but so far I haven't found it. And the problem is it's got all the usual poison like aluminum and formaldehyde and genetic material from aborted babies and all the usual stuff. But those can be detoxed. And the one that changes your DNA, they've made it so apparently permanent that it goes to future generations, if there are any. So I don't know the answer to that yet, but I see that as a situation that looks like it's coming up. Except for a lot of people, they hope won't know it, because they're going to call the vaccine deaths COVID deaths, proving the need for more vaccines.
Right, and of course, in part of the manipulation is on inauguration day for Biden. What do? They reduce the number of cycles that they use in the PCR test, so it's going to look like
He cured about half of it overnight.
That's how you're
being liberal.
Yeah, you don't really have to cure anything. All you've got to do is count the votes. In other words, you change the outcome of the testing, and it makes it look like it's being cured.
Yeah, but it's tricky, and they need some skill to do this right. I mean, you have to respect how good they are at it, because at the same time as showing that he's curing it, you have to show that it's so terribly exploding that everybody needs a vaccine every month.
Yeah.
I think they realized that, wow, we could give a vaccine to everybody on the planet. And then they thought, wow, how stupid. Why would we only do that once? Mm-hmm. We can do it constantly. And keep it voluntary, where nobody can get out of their house or eventually a detention camp, but they can decide on their own what they want to do.
Something so effective that you have to mandate its use or force people into it, and you have to have a compensation program for those who are injured because it's so safe.
Yeah, exactly. The compensation's hard to get, but there is one.
Right. And of course, you're going to make the taxpayers pay the compensation because
that's right.
Why hold the pharmaceutical companies accountable like every other business is accountable for their...
No, that would be racist, of course.
Probably and, racist.
And in the last week, or something too. Joe Biden authorized $4 billion for the money that's going partly to Gavi and these other vaccine programs.
And if anyone wants to know more about Gavi, please go to OrbisVitae.com and go to the forum section and look at the video called, it's a video with Dr. David Ayoub. I absolutely love his lecture. It's one of my favorite lectures of all time.
David
Ayoub, A-Y-O-U-B.
Oh, okay. A-Y-O-O-D.
V, yeah, Ayoub, or B, like boy, Ayoub. Dr. David Ayoub, it's and we have titled the video, What Vaccines Have Done to Your Body. This talks about Bill Gates' funding of Gavi, and what the result was after this was given out in a third world area.
Okay.
That the women, the pregnant women, were running and hiding.
They're smart, yeah.
Yeah, because they saw what was happening to their colleagues, to their friends.
And this is a medical doctor, right?
Yes.
Some of the medical doctors have survived the cult training, and it's really impressive. They still have some common sense.
It's a common sense will transform your life.
Yeah, yeah, I think it would help save the world, actually.
This is why, you know, if I wanted to elect somebody president, I think if I could just find a guy with common sense, he could change the world.
It's going to be a big project to look for that, though.
Well, they're out there. I know people.
I know they do have some.
Yeah, yeah. Well, we know them. We know them. It's just it's hard to get them on the ticket for election. That's
well, exactly. They don't really feel like being assassinated right away.
Right, or they'll lock you up, handcuff you in the basement like they did to, was it Herman Cain? I can't remember his name, but they locked one guy during the debates up to the basement so they wouldn't show up to the debate. They did. This was years ago.
I mean, the country's ruled by a network of mafias, and that's probably an insult to regular mafias because they're worse than people think about that stuff. But I would like to hear how things develop on your new project.
Absolutely. And thank you for the opportunity for being on. And thank you. I see your interviews on all the time, and I can't keep up my own to-do list, but I do see all the time. I mean, just putting the info out. So I appreciate what you do very much.
We're all on the same team.
Yes.
So, okay. Have a good night.
All right. You too. You too. Doug, it's good hearing your voice again.
Thank you so much, Russ. It was great catching up with you.
Even though
it was just for a second.
Yeah.
Thank you, guys.
We'll stay in touch.
Yes, absolutely. Thank you.
Okay. All right. Bye.
All right. Take care. Bye-bye.